In today's video, I'll introduce the Precision Drawing Tools extension. The PDT is a free extension and is very useful for precision modeling. Just go to Edit, Preferences, Get Extensions, and install it. And make sure to also install extra mesh objects. As the technical drawing is in millimeters, let's change a couple settings. On scene, set unit scale to 0.001 and length to millimeters. Let's create the top base mesh. On PDT design operations, I'll basically use to place the 3D cursor. As the width is 80 mm, let's set the X coordinate to -40 mm and hit absolute. With the 3D cursor at -40 mm on the X axis, let's create a single vert. Press Shift plus A to add and add single vert. Now we need to extrude this vertex 80 mm on the X axis. Press E to extrude, X to lock the axis, type 80 to move it 80 mm, and hit Enter to confirm. The depth is 40 mm, so let's extrude these two vertices 40 mm on the Y axis. Press A to select all, Alt plus Z to extrude, and select Extrude Vertices. Now press Y to lock the axis, type -40, and Enter to confirm. To close the shape, just press F to create a new edge. Now let's create two 10 mm radius arcs on the selected vertices. Press Shift plus Ctrl plus B for vertex bevel, type 10, and increase segments to 16. Now we need to add two 8 mm diameter circles. But first we need to find these arc center points. To find an arc center point, select three vertices from an arc and hit this arc center button here. Now the 3D cursor is at the center and we can create the first circle. Press Shift plus A to add and create a mesh circle. Here I'll leave vertices at 32 and for the radius, just type the diameter divided by 2. Now just repeat the same steps to create the other circle. To finish the top mesh, let's fill some faces and add thickness. As this is a hard surface object, I do not aim for quad topology. As a matter of fact, for this type of objects, I like to create the least amount of faces I can. And if I have to, I can always use a quad remesher. For this mesh, three faces will be enough. Select the left-hand corner and press F to create a new face. Select the right-hand corner and press F to create a new face. Now select all remaining vertices and fill the last face. The height is 10 mm, so let's extrude these faces 10 mm on the Z axis. But before that, let's flip these inverted normals. Press A to select all, Alt plus N for normals, and flip them. Now press E to extrude, type 10, and Enter to confirm. The top base mesh is complete. We can now press Tab to exit edit mode, F2 to rename, and H to hide in viewport. Now let's create the front base mesh. As this is almost the same as the top view, I'm going to speed up this part. Just notice that the height here is 30 mm and the arcs have 8 mm radius. When it's done, exit edit mode, rename it Boolean 01 and hide in viewport. Let's create this 40 by 35 by 30 mm cube. As the width is 40 mm, let's set the X coordinate to -20 mm and hit absolute. With the 3D cursor at -20 mm on the X axis, let's create a single vert. Press Shift plus A to add and add single vert. Now we need to extrude this vertex 40 mm on the X axis. Press E to extrude, X to lock the axis, type 40 and Enter to confirm. The depth is 35 mm, so let's extrude this edge by 35 mm on the Y axis. Press A to select all, E to extrude, Y to lock the axis, type -35 and Enter to confirm. The height is 30 mm, so let's extrude this face by 30 mm on the Z axis. But before that, let's flip the normals. Press A to select all, Alt plus N for normals, and flip. Press E to extrude, type 30, and Enter to confirm. Now exit edit mode, rename it Boolean 02, and hide in viewport. Let's create this 15 by 35 mm cylinder. As this is aligned to the top, let's set the Z coordinate to 30 mm and hit absolute. with the 3D cursor 30mm on the Z-axis, let's create a circle. Press Shift plus A to add, and add a mesh circle. Here I'll set the vertices to 128, the radius to 15mm, and the X rotation to 90 degrees. The depth is 35mm, so let's extrude this by 35mm on the Y-axis. Press Tab to go to Edit Mode, and F to create a new face. Now E to extrude, type 35, and Enter to confirm. Exit Edit Mode, and rename it Bool Sub 01. Now let's unhide all meshes, and move them into Collections. To unhide all, just press Alt plus H. We're going to need two Boolean collections here, one to add and one to subtract. Select both Bool-add meshes, press M to move to collection, click New Collection, and rename it Bool-add. Select the Bool submesh, press M to move to collection, click New Collection, and rename it Bool sub. Now uncheck both to exclude them from view layer. To join these meshes together, we're going to use modifiers. With the base mesh selected, go to Modifiers and add a Boolean modifier. Set it to Union, type to Collection, select the Bool-add collection, and set the solver to Manifold. Add another Boolean modifier, set it to Difference, type to Collection, select the Bool sub collection, and set the solver to Manifold. To finish, let's apply the modifiers and clean the mesh. Press Ctrl plus A to apply both modifiers, Tab to go to Edit Mode, Edge to select all, and M to merge by distance. Enable Edge Selection, and select these unnecessary edges here. Now press X to delete, and select Dissolve Edges. For less, press Tab to exit Edit Mode, Ctrl plus A to apply location, and right mouse to Shade Auto Smooth. If you enjoyed this new format, make sure to drop a like and leave a comment. Your feedback is very important to improve the quality of the videos. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye-bye.